Listen, the Lord himself will give you a sign. The virgin will give birth to a son and will name him Emmanuel, which means God with us. For unto us a child will be born, a son will be given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace.
And so it came pass, as predicted by the prophet Isaiah, that a child was to be born. So God sent the angel Gabriel to the town of Nazareth, to a young woman who was to be married to a man named Joseph. The virgin's name was Mary.
Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid. You will give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus.
He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God.
How will this be when I'm not married?
The Holy Spirit will come upon him, and the power of God will overcome him.
So the child to be born will be called the Son of God.
This is as God has promised, and God always keeps his promises.
I am the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled.
Good job, my
son. The good man who will be both the law and God.
But after discovering that Mary was pregnant,
he was uncertain what to do. Therefore, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife.
But she is a child.
She is to give birth to the Son of God, a gift from the Holy Spirit. The child will be a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary as his wife.
Caesar Augustus declaring the law. A census will be taken to count all the people in the country. All the men will come to Bethlehem to be counted.
So Joseph went from Nazareth to Bethlehem, the city of David, with Mary who is expecting a child.
We're here for the census to be counted. Is there anywhere we can stay?
There are many in town to be counted. There's no room.
Please, my wife is a child. Is there anywhere we can stay?
There's no room to be in, but we have a stable for the animals. If you need a place to sleep, you can stay there.
We'll stay in the stable. Thank you.
While they were there, it was time for the child to be born, and Mary gave birth to a son.
There's a baby! Oh, let me take a picture of the baby.
She wrapped him in clothes and held her in her arms.
There's a baby.
There were shepherds living in the nearby fields and tending to their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were so afraid.
What is that light?
Who's there?
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all of you.
Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
worship.
When the shepherds saw the baby lying in the manger, they praised God. They spread the word about the child, telling everyone the good news, and all who heard it were amazed.
Aww.
Perfect.
Far from Bethlehem, wise men from the east watched the night sky. One night they saw a star shining brightly. They knew the statement, the special child had been born.
It is the star of Bethlehem. It is a sign we've been waiting for.
The child has been born.
Come, let us follow the star. We'll take gifts to honor the child.
So the wise men traveled across the desert to find Jesus. The wise men bowed down to worship him and gave their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. This is the true meaning of Christmas, the true story of the first Christmas. Now in this time of year, we celebrate the birth of Jesus because he brought the good news of God's love to the world.